Roth here. Welcome to my world, where it's naturally supernatural. One of my guests, Richard Roberts, said to me, Sid, this is going to be one of the great healing services of history. Hank Kunneman, a well-recognized prophet, one of the more accurate prophets that I've met, he said many, many things right on air with us that have come to pass. He said, and Richard agreed, that when you combine prophecy and healing together, it's going to cause an explosion of miracles. Are you ready?
Yeah!
Get ready to receive your miracle, your breakthrough, your healing. Join Sid Roth and his special guests, Hank Kunneman, Richard Roberts, and worship leader Eddie James for this live TV event, Healing and the Prophetic. And now, here's your host, Sid Roth.
Well, this show is starting so spectacular. Okay, I really like to welcome our ISN viewers as well as our broadcast partners, GB America and METV, which covers Israel and the entire Middle East. And I'm so excited about this very special live healing and prophetic program. How about you? Now, my first guest, Hank Kunneman, is really one of the most accurate prophets of this generation. His prophecies regarding 9/11, America's promise and future, prophecies for the nations of the world, and even his word from God saying, I will make America great again. No, that was not Donald Trump first. That was this guest right now, Hank Kunneman. Hank. Now, I'm going to really blow your mind. You ready? If I haven't already. Yeah. I mean, starting on live TV all over the world. Hank, you told me that you had, I don't know if it was a dream or a vision, of you sitting at this desk and me asking you a question. Well, I would have asked you that question anyway. You didn't need a dream for it.
Yeah, right.
And he saw me, but here's the part that's so neat. He saw me ask this question, which I always ask him anyway, even when he's not on the show.
Right.
But God arrested him and gave him a different answer. This was the question in the dream that Hank saw me ask. Hank! So what do you see happening this year?
This year. Anyway, it's an honor to be here. I did see that question being asked of you in my dream, and the Lord spoke in the dream, and here's what he said. He said, Hank, that is too limited. He said, I want to broaden the perspective of the people, that they understand it's not just what I'm doing this year, but what I'm doing in the now. This is important, in the now. Now, the now can span through this year. It can span through next year, the coming years, when God moves in the now. Here's how you know. Jesus' first miracle, he turned water into aged wine, the best wine for last. It was accelerated time. It was also now that he moved and presented that to the governor of the feast. And it says that this is the beginning of miracles that Jesus did. Well, we know that it was the miracle in the now, it was accelerated time, but it was also the beginning of miracles, meaning that it hasn't stopped. In fact, I hear the Spirit of God say this, I am the God who moves in the now, and now my glory is coming upon this nation, the United States, and it's coming upon the nations of the earth, and it's coming fast, says the Spirit of God. United States, you shall be united as what bears your name.
Oh,
for now I move upon your land to expose, to bring great exposure, to cause the covers to be pulled back so that I may show this nation and the earth what is taking place. Legislative changes shall swiftly come as a reform is upon you. For this reform is to reverse that which was penned by the arrogance of men. Watch what I'm about to do, says the Spirit of God. I'm establishing righteousness and rightness upon your courts. For this is a supreme thing, isn't it? Says the Spirit of grace. Watch, for even in the wombs, the children have leaped. They have lived. But yet, many have not been given the right to live. But the Spirit of God says, now, this is in process of changing in your land, United States. And the children in the womb, they shall not only leap upon the soil of your land, but they shall breathe the freshness of the breath, the freshness of the air of the nation. Spirit of God says, Canada, do not fear. For you, watch what happened in the United States. I have not forgotten you, O Canada. And the Spirit of God says, even though the enemy whispers into the ear of the ones that are seated in your government to bring contrary to what I have planned and those that have prayed, the Spirit of God says there is a wind of change that shall begin to blow throughout Canada, from British Columbia to Quebec. And there is a move that shall change legislatively. And you will see that the finest day is soon to come upon you in the now. For this is my plan, says the Spirit of God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
I'll tell you, I don't know about you, but the Holy Spirit is just bubbling up within me. There's something. This really is going to be a special, special show. God lets you see something that it must have been wonderful. God lets you see through His eyes.
Yes.
Explain.
This happened to me just a few Sundays ago. I was standing on the front row of the church that I pastor in Omaha, Nebraska. And I was worshiping the Lord, and all of a sudden said, I felt like somebody threw a coat on me. And I knew it was the Lord, like a heavy coat. It was so heavy, I could hardly stand. I could hardly walk to the platform to transition the service. All of a sudden, I saw a pair of eyes. I said, Lord, what is this? He said, Hank, I'm allowing you to see through my eyes for events that are coming in the now for the nations. And it's almost like if you ever downloaded files on a computer, they go real fast. Mm-hmm. That's how fast things were moving through the eyes of the Lord that I was looking through and being downloaded in my spirit. And I really believe that there is things that are happening by the Spirit of God that if we limit it to a time, we will miss the bigger picture of what God is trying to reveal in the now. He's up to good. And His glory is coming, and it's coming fast. Listen to me, Cuba. Spirit of God says to you, you have waited and you've wondered, what is taking place in Cuba? But the Spirit of God says, I have not forgotten you, for I'm going to unbuckle you to set you free. And even in China, there is the sound of the underground of those who pray in tongues and pray. And what is underground in Asia? The Spirit of God says, shall come above ground, and this shall shock the world as my church begins to come to the forefront and to the light. But watch the soil of Asia. First it shall shake in the natural, and then you shall know that suddenly that which is underground shall be shaken loose to come forward. And let it be known even unto you, said the Spirit of God says, that I have placed you in the Middle East, but oh, watch what I'm about to open, not only in Europe, but I'm about to open up even in Asia, an effectual door of utterance. Why? To handle this move of my spirit and awakening that is coming to the earth, and it's coming fast. Thank you, Lord.
You know, Hank, God has given you a revelation on a subject I have never heard anyone even teach on. And that is the Bible talks about wind, and the Bible talks about a north wind, a south, a east, a west. You have revelation that when you get this knowledge and pray according to biblical knowledge, you get amazing results. Take one wind and give me an example.
All right. First, let me just say this. Ezekiel prophesied to the four winds externally.
Yes.
We, through the Holy Spirit, prophesy with the four winds in our mouth. I'll give you one example. The east wind, you can read all four winds in Job 37. The east wind is a wind of judgment against the enemy. It's a wind of breakthrough. It's also a wind of correction.
Now, I have to ask you this question. You get very specific on the winds. You tell us how to pray. But why do we have to be specific? God knows. Why do I have to say north winds or south wind? I was wondering that.
Well, the Bible says that there is a language and there is a speech where our voice will not be heard. In other words, what's going to be heard, it cannot be contained. And God's talking about His church. When we're specific, okay, we are decreeing a thing, as the Scripture says, and it will be established. When I decree the north wind, for example, which is...
I'll tell you what, would you do me a favor?
Yes.
Would you make a decree of the north wind right now that heaven is going to move on?
In the name of Jesus, I decree from my mouth and the authority that I stand in, and I decree with the north wind, let there come an awakening unto the earth and unto this nation. And I decree from the north the cleansing rain of God's presence. Let it begin to come and fall upon the land. For in the United States, welcome your rain. Welcome your wind. For even in the natural, this is your sign of what is taking place from the north wind of my spirit to rain down righteousness in my presence again.
You know, I have to tell you, for years, I've been interviewing you and a number of other prophets, and you've been almost like a lone voice. Everyone else is saying gloom and doom. I couldn't get you to say that. Well, didn't it bother you that everyone else was saying gloom and doom?
Happened to Micaiah. There was 400 prophets of Ahab that were prophesying according to what Ahab was wanting, you know, to go to war. But Micaiah was the 401st. So sometimes I'm not the only one. There's other prophets that sometimes we have to hear from the third heaven. That's the throne room. That's the highest place. And really what it comes down to is God's heart. When you communicate and you're
after
God's
heart. So are you indicating that some prophets hear from the second heaven,
yes,
which is the devil's realm, and rather than the third heaven? Is that what I'm hearing you say?
That's what happened with the 400 prophets.
Oh, okay. All right.
They were horn prophets. They were horn prophets. Zedekiah wore horns on his head, trying to act all powerful and mighty. We have to be careful. That's the warfare realm. We cannot use the horn of our anointing or power wrong to give the land what it wants. When you're a third heaven prophet, you're after God's heart. And always remember this, God always has, whether it's a warning or a word to you or a nation, God always has a redemptive plan. And the Spirit of God said to me, he said, as long as my spirit is in the earth, I always have a redemptive plan. Even if a warning comes, what is a redemptive plan? Sid, a redemptive plan is God's message of help and his message of hope. And that's why people get caught up in doom and gloom, because they're excluding the redemptive side of God, who
right,
always wants to help, who always wants to bring hope in the midst.
You know what? It's almost like many Christians want to see the demise of America.
Right.
I don't get it. Frankly, I don't. Now, God has always, even from the beginning, wanted to use man's voice. Comment on that.
God has always longed to use man's voice. He wants to use your voice. And the reason why he wants to use our voice is because of the authority that we carry in the earth as his sons and daughters, as his representatives. And when we speak, we are speaking with his authority and with his power, and we can shift regions and territories. We can even cause our own life that maybe it's not going well. When we start declaring, Lord, I'm blessed. Lord, I declare that your blessings are coming upon me. We are shifting things, and we also are breaking the powers of darkness that uses words to release agendas and assignments against us.
You know something I've been doing now for years, and when I first started, I wasn't sure, because things were coming apart, but people would say, how are you? And here in the South where I live, that's like saying hello. I actually thought when someone says, how are you, they're really interested in how I am. So I begin to tell them, and then I started saying, I am a blessed man of God. And some will giggle, and some, but guess what? It's like a magnet. The blessings of God are coming to me because I've been saying it, even when things were awful. Now, by the way, speaking of God's voice on the earth, Richard Roberts tells you a little understood truth, how to grab hold of your miracle right after this.
We will return with more of our special presentation of Healing and the Prophetic.
The supernatural of God knows no bounds, and now there are no limits to equipping you to receive your supernatural miracle anytime, any place. ISN, The It's Supernatural online network is now available for your mobile devices and smart TVs.
The message of the Bible has not changed, but it's a 21st century world out there. And how we learn about God's miraculous direction for our lives has changed. ISN takes our anointed programs out of the box and gives you complete freedom to watch what you want, when you want, and where you want.
ISN offers live streaming of programs 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, right on your mobile devices or smart TVs. Or you can choose from dozens of powerful episodes of exclusive programs in our online library. Get ready to receive your supernatural breakthrough whenever you need it, wherever you are. Download the free ISN app today.
And now, back to our special presentation of Healing and the Prophetic.
But it must have been, I know your story, Richard, but to be raised with one of the giants of men or women of God that move in miracles, but not even raised with him at his side at so many of his meetings. Mm-hmm. I mean, you can see God's hand on your life from the very beginning. But tell me what you saw with your own eyes, two creative miracles of your dad.
Well, I've got to tell you, Sid, and by the way, it's a joy to be with you as always on
Thank
the Supernatural.
You.
I am seeing what I saw. Just as you began, I saw God begin to heal and lengthen a left leg, a leg that is shorter than the other leg. And someone's left leg, which is several inches shorter, is growing out right now. Now, that's a creative miracle today. Thank God for what happened in the past, but God's still moving in the creative world today. And I give praise and honor and glory.
I agree.
Sid, the one that really stands out to me is the one that you and I have talked about before, was a little boy that was born without a hip socket. And when his mother brought him into the prayer line, he was about my age. And my dad read the prayer card and said to the woman, "I am so sorry. I just don't have faith for a creative miracle." The woman took the microphone and said, "Brother Roberts, I don't ask you to have any faith at all. You just pray and I'll do the believing." And he prayed. And seemingly nothing happened. The little boy left on his crutches and the metal brace, and he went off the same way he came on. But the next night when we got to the tent, they had the little boy up on the platform, and he was running and jumping. He didn't have a crutch. His shoe was not built up. There was no metal brace. And he was running and jumping, and my father went over and put his hand on the place where he'd put it the night before, where his hip was all sunken in because there was no hip socket. And right. In the night, God had supernaturally created a hip socket.
You know.
And he's still doing that today. Someone's left leg, which is shorter than the other, is supernaturally being lengthened. And you're going to find, in fact, before this program is over, someone's going to find that their leg has grown out to the exact length of their other leg.
You know, Richard, I've read a lot about your dad, and the devil tried to get rid of him before he got started. He had, which was really a fatal type of disease back then, TB.
Yes.
And God spoke to him about his call. What did he say?
He said, "Son, I am going to heal you, and you're to take my healing power to your generation." And when his older brother, my oldest uncle and aunt, my oldest aunt, his sister, took him to a healing meeting, a man prayed a different kind of prayer. He didn't say, "Lord, if it be your will, heal this boy of tuberculosis." Instead, he said, "You foul, tormenting sickness, I adjure you by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, come out of this boy, loose him, and set him free." Someone's liable to get healed right now as I'm praying that prayer right now, because the power of God is just as strong now as it was then. As the power of God came up his feet, up his legs, into his body, suddenly he could breathe without hemorrhaging. Before, for the period of 5 months, when he would cough, he would hemorrhage and spit blood across the room, and he had lost the power to walk. But suddenly the power of God came in. He could breathe all the way in, breathe all the way out. He had been born a stutterer, could hardly say his name, especially when he was under pressure. They put a microphone in his face, and he talked for 10 minutes before he realized he hadn't stuttered once. That was the beginning of the healing ministry of something supernatural.
So, this is what interests me. Is one day your dad was praying for you, and he said something to the effect, "I didn't know about your future." What did he see about your future?
Well, Sid, I had not wanted to be a Christian because I'd seen all the stuff that had happened to him.
I know. It was kind of bittersweet.
I wanted my own life. I wanted to be a nightclub entertainer. I have been offered.
By the way, if you're a nightclub entertainer, you're just a misguided evangelist, psalmist.
The entertainment business needs Jesus too.
For sure.
But I wanted my own life. But I became ill, and my father came in to pray for me, which he had done many times in my life. And when he reached out his hand to touch me, before he did, he said, "I had no idea that the anointing of God for healing was on my son." Now, it had been prophesied over me when I was a little boy, but I had forgotten about it, and I had wanted to get away from God. And he began to tell me of what I would do in my life. He said, "I see you standing before great crowds, before presidents and prime ministers and kings and queens in crusades all over the world." He said, "I see you with a double portion of the anointing that I have had, and I see you having twice as many miracles." He said, "I had to lay hands on people. That's the way God used me. You will have the operation of the word of knowledge. You'll be on television. You'll have crowds too big to lay hands on people. So I will use your voice," the Lord said through him, and just like a moment ago when I gave that word, and people will be healed when you speak. Now, that's what happened that day, and everything he prophesied has come to pass.
Now, I said that to say this. I believe that Richard, in the next few minutes, is going to give you a revelation, not that God heals, not that there was as much physical healing in the atonement as forgiveness of sin, but how to receive that healing. You recently taught on the subject of miracles are coming towards us or past us.
Yes.
Tell me why they go past us. Well, I'd rather know how to come into me, receive it.
Well, just look at the scripture, Sid. Here you see Jesus with a great crowd, and the Bible speaks of two or three that were healed. Miracles were coming toward the people, or they were going past the people. Some who wanted to be in the atmosphere to receive, some who didn't want to be in the atmosphere to receive. And if you study the Bible, you'll find that he was either on his way to heal somebody, or he was there healing them, or he was on his way to heal somebody else. So miracles were constantly passing by. What we have to learn how to do is to use our faith. It's not just his power. His power is important, certainly, but we have to use our faith. His power and our faith have to come together. It's like you take your left hand and you squeeze and you feel that power there. Squeeze your left hand there and then squeeze your other hand. You feel that power. But now put them together and you see you have much more power. You have his power and you have your faith coming together. And it happens through a point of contact. A point of contact is something that you do, and when you release your faith, you get yourself into an atmosphere for healing. The woman who touched the border of his garment, the woman with the issue of blood, made the border of his garment, which was more than likely a prayer shawl, which had tassels at the base, representing the law of Moses, which was the word of God.
Right.
She made the word of God a point of contact. She said, really what she was saying was, if I can just get my hands on the word of God, I will release my faith. And as soon as she touched it, her faith was released because Jesus whirled around and said, "Who has touched me?" Now, she touched the tassels on his garment, but he said, "Someone has touched me." We can touch him by our faith. We can release our faith. People say to me, "Well, Richard, how do you release your faith?" Well, you turn it loose. How do you turn it loose? You let it go. Faith. When I receive this prayer in the name of Jesus, I release my faith to you and I receive a miracle.
You really teach grabbing it.
Yes.
Grabbing a hold like that woman with the issue of blood, she grabbed.
Well, doesn't the Bible say the violent take it by force?
Yes.
She took it. She said, it's mine. I claim that. When my father prophesied a double portion of his spirit on me, I said, Lord, I want that. I claim that in Jesus' name. That's mine in the name of Jesus. And that's what she was doing. And Jesus whirled around and said, someone has touched me. She told him the truth. He said, woman, your faith, your believing, the fact that you have released your faith has set you free. Now, sometimes healing comes quickly. Sometimes healing comes over a period of time. And we often think, because we live in a microwave society, that if it doesn't happen instantaneously, there's something wrong with God or there's something wrong with me. But if you remember when Jesus went to Jericho and spoke to that fig tree and commanded that it would not bear fruit any longer, seemingly nothing happened. But when they came out of town the next day, it had dried up from the roots. Something was happening on the inside of the tree that was not visible to the disciples. Yes. But the next day, Peter said, look, the tree you cursed yesterday has withered up from the roots. And Jesus said, have faith in God. Or in other words, release your faith and believe that something's happening on the inside. And oftentimes when I pray for people, they say, well, I didn't feel an instantaneous healing. Well, who knows? It might come by the end of this program. It might come tomorrow. It might come next week. That's why we hold on in faith and continue to release our faith and say, I'm not coming out of this prayer of agreement until the miracle is manifested.
Richard, I was in Ukraine, and I said something I have never said before. Imagine you're at the beach, and there is the big, soft beach ball, you know, the one you blow up with your own breath. And I was to toss this to you. I said this to the audience. And what are you going to do, let it hit you in the face, or are you going to do what Richard said? Grab it to yourself. Mm-hmm. Richard, you're having people healed of stage 4 cancer, so many people getting... Tell me a quick story of one person.
I just got a testimony just this morning of a woman who called for prayer. She had a fibroid tumor the size of a grapefruit. And when we prayed, she said, the thing just went flat. The doctor said, it's no longer there. She released her faith. I wasn't there to lay hands on her. I didn't have a word of knowledge for her. But when I prayed, she took hold of her faith and let it go to God, and the fibroid tumor disappeared. We just got another testimony from a woman who had been diagnosed with stage 4 cancer. And she's the one you're referring to. Just about 3 weeks ago, I got this testimony. Mm-hmm. She had called into our Abundant Life prayer group, and we had prayed, and they had brought the prayer request to me. We prayed. She called back and said, I went back to the doctor again. Now they cannot find a trace of cancer in my body. It is gone. What God did, He's still doing. He hasn't changed.
You know, I really believe that when you and Hank start praying, and I believe that, and now you take to heart what Richard's talking about. I want you, when they speak a word, a prophetic word that is for you, I want you to, just like that, I don't want that beach ball to pass you by. Mm-hmm. I want you to catch that beach ball, catch that healing. Almost as if your own hands, and this is another revelation God's given me, you have a spirit, your spirit's in your belly. Imagine the hands of your spirit, because you have spirit hands as well as regular, coming out of your spirit and grabbing that healing and take it because it's yours. Now, when we come back, Hank Kunneman and Richard Roberts are here to reveal how healing and the prophetic work together for supernatural results. That sounds like a breakthrough to me. Do you need a breakthrough? I know you do. Here is a man that recently got back from heaven, Eddie James, and breakthrough.
You are the undefeated one, my light and my salvation. When the wicked, my enemies and my foes came upon me to eat of my flesh, they stumbled and fell.
Come on, put your hands together. Let's celebrate Jesus.
Omnipotent, almighty defender, you're my victory, my refuge, the one I run to. You are the God, you are the God. If He's the God of your breakthrough tonight, come on, clap your hands up high and shout breakthrough, breakthrough for you.
A breakthrough has come to your business. Come on. Breakthrough in my worship. Breakthrough in my praise. Breakthrough when I lift and glorify your name. Breakthrough when I dance. Breakthrough when I shout. You are the God. Breakthrough in my heart. Breakthrough in my mind. Breakthrough in my spirit. Breakthrough in my soul. Breakthrough in my weakness. Breakthrough in my struggle. You are the God. You are worship. Breakthrough when I praise. Breakthrough when I lift and glorify your name. Breakthrough when I dance. Somebody ought to shout. You are the God. You are the God of the breakthrough in my heart. Breakthrough in my mind. Breakthrough in my spirit. Breakthrough in my soul. Breakthrough in my weakness. Breakthrough in my struggle. You are the God. When I praise, when I lift and glorify your name, when I dance, when I shout, hopefully you are the God. You are the God. Tonight, things are shifting. Tonight, things are changing. Tonight, you're receiving miracles. You're receiving deliverance. So breakthrough in my worship, breakthrough in my praise, breakthrough when I lift and glorify your name, breakthrough when I dance, breakthrough when I shout. You are the God. You are the God of the... Somebody say it. Breakthrough. 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 You are the God. You are the God of the... Come on, declare it. Come on and shout it. Come on, decree it. And prophesy it. It is yours. Oh, for you are the God. You are the God of the breakthrough. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
We will return with more of our special presentation of Healing and the Prophetic. Call now and get the Healing and the Prophetic package, exclusive to our It's Supernatural audience. It includes Hank Kunneman's book, Prophesy with the Wind of God in Your Mouth, plus his prophetic two-part audio CD teaching, A Throne Room Perspective of the Now, and What Does a Nation Look Like Filled with Glory? And you will receive Richard Roberts' audio CD teaching, Miracles Are Coming Toward You or Going Past You Every Day. All yours for a donation of $29. Shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 9470. You will receive receive Richard Roberts' anointed audio CD teaching. Miracles are coming toward you or going past you every day. You will find out how to remove every obstacle to receiving your healing. Learn that this is God's season of His glory being released on planet Earth. Understand the keys to grabbing onto your healing, your miracle, your breakthrough. Richard Roberts prays for God to release to you His healing and your miracle. You will receive Hank Kunneman's book, Prophesy with the Wind of God in Your Mouth. Through this book, you will learn that it's always been God's desire to use His people to speak and be His voice on earth. Learn the key on how to declare and decree words that drive away the enemy and bring deliverance. Declare words that reach heaven, bringing you a spiritual breakthrough of prosperity, restoration, and blessings. You will also receive Hank Kunneman's prophetic audio CD teaching, What Does a Nation Look Like Filled with Glory? Through it, you will learn how the glory will cause ungodly laws to be overturned, wipe terrorists off the face of the earth, cause leaders in high places to cry out for God's mercy and divine wisdom, cause children to be praying in schools again, cause the Supreme Court to overturn abortion, bring about a supernatural wealth transfer and debt cancellation. You will also receive Hank Kunneman's second audio CD teaching, A Throne Room Perspective of the Now. Through this exclusive audio CD teaching, you will begin to see the world around you through God's throne room perspective. Understand the way of escape from the circumstances and dangers confronting you. Learn how to take advantage of the season of glory being released upon America, Israel, and the nations. Be a part of a mighty revival, with stadiums and the streets themselves being filled with miracles, signs, and wonders. Don't miss out on getting the healing and the prophetic package, exclusive to our rich supernatural audience. It includes Hank Kunneman's book, Prophesy with the Wind of God in Your Mouth, plus his prophetic two-part audio CD teaching, A Throne Room Perspective of the Now, and What Does a Nation Look Like Filled with Glory? And you will receive Richard Roberts' audio CD teaching, Miracles Are Coming Toward You or Going Past You Every Day. All yours for a donation of $29. Shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 9470. Call or you can send your check to Sid Roth. It's supernatural. P.O. Box 39222, Charlotte, North Carolina 28278. Please specify offer number 9470 or log on to sidroth.org. Call or write today. And now, back to our special presentation of Healing and the Prophetic.
During the break, Richard, God spoke to you. Yeah. What did He say?
Well, as Eddie, thank you. Yeah, thank you, Lord. Eardrums are opening up right now in the name of Jesus. A deafness is leaving. There's a person, it's a man, you've had a terrible problem with varicose veins on your right leg. And those veins are just going flat right now. And then the other word I got as Eddie was just ministering. There's a tumor. There's a person who has a tumor on the left side of your back. And you've been diagnosed with skin cancer as well as there is cancer in the tumor. And that tumor is just dissolving now. And someone's going to go back to the doctor and find out the cancer is gone. And you'll be testifying to Sid and letting him know and the staff here know what God is doing. I release that into your life now in the name of Jesus.
Well, let me go a step further. Not someone. You! It has your name on it. You've got a tumor. What just happened to them?
Well, I just saw the tumor dissolve. It's on the left side of your back. I saw it dissolve, and I saw cancer come out. And someone will go back to the doctor and find out the cancer's gone.
Yeah, but
you've also been out of work. And because of that cancer, you've been out of work. And the Spirit of God says, not only is it a work of restoration for your body, but it is a work of restoration that shall give your life back, including your job and resources shall soon be released too.
You know, both of you said something to me before we went on the air, and you said both of you want to talk about the blood right. Hank, tell me about the blood.
Something is happening over the United States right now, and it's why as I'm watching protests, as I'm watching violence in the streets, I'm saying, do you understand what really is happening? There is a blood right that God is revisiting. For example, we have a blood right through Jesus Christ to bind the enemy. There's an illegal authority because of shed blood. There's spirits that are attached to blood, okay? When Jesus died on the cross, the Holy Spirit was released, okay? The enemy understands certain blood rights. There's also rights of healing through the blood. We know that by the stripes of Jesus Christ. Think about this. this current administration that is serving in the land of the United States, why of all places, 9/11 took place, God hears the sound of blood. He smells blood. It's come into the ears of the Lord Sabaoth. And I knew after 9/11, the Lord said, watch, from the place of New York, I will raise up a president. And he's been saying this for years, because I'm revisiting a blood right, a legal right for my church to have authority to bring my glory and to heal the United States. Now, watch this. This current administration, he's from New York City, the place of 9/11. Yes. He has a tower. The towers were attacked in 9/11. He represents World Trade. The World Trade towers were attacked. What is God up to? He's up to healing this nation, the United States. We're not to call it America. We're to call it the United States. And the Lord is going to... The Spirit of God says, listen to me. Your health care, the health care that is being bickering and fighting right now, the Spirit of God says, this is a sign to you, United States. For I will push them to the table, the left, the right, and the middle, so that I can show this nation that I am the one that's bringing a unity, uniting the United States. Do you think, says the Spirit of God, that I am cold-hearted, unconcerned, uncaring regarding the healing of this nation and the healing of the nations? I have listened to the prayers of those. It did not matter, Republican, Democrat, other. God said, they prayed and said, Lord, heal our land. And so I am revisiting this land again. And I am raising it up to be great, says the Lord again. This is my saying and this is my doing. Watch what I do to release my power upon this land to heal it and to bring unity, says the Spirit of God.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Richard, what has God shown you about blood right? You said that's very important.
Well, if you remember, Jesus took 39 stripes on his back. In those days, 40 stripes was a death sentence. Mm-hmm. And so the scriptures say 40 save one, or 39 stripes. Each stripe was for a sickness and disease. I read a medical report that said all sickness and disease have been put into 39 categories. Science is confirming the Word of God. He took a stripe for every sickness and disease known to mankind. And we have a right, we have a covenant right, we have a blood right because of the atonement, because of what he did when he took the stripes on his back. So therefore, when you pray, you're not going to a God saying, well, I'm not sure what God's will is. No, no, no. It's not like that prayer that was prayed over my father. Lord, if it be your will, heal this boy. No, no, no. The other man prayed, Lord, in the authority of Jesus' name, I rebuke this tuberculosis. I command it to come out. You have a Bible right. You have a covenant right with God through the shed blood of Jesus for salvation and for healing. But it doesn't happen automatically. You've got to reach out and let your faith go in Jesus' name.
You know, I'm reminded of the scripture in Revelation. The devil himself is overcome by the blood of the Lamb.
And
the blood of the Lamb and
the word of his testimony.
Hank, you were minding your own business one day, walking your dog, and a cloud shows up. What happened?
This happened to me last summer. I have two German Shepherd dogs. And if you know anything about German Shepherds, they're very high-energy dogs. As I was walking, it was a very bright and sunny day. I feel like Brother Hagin when you used to say bright and sunny day. But it was a very bright and sunny day. There wasn't a cloud in the sky, and I was walking my two German Shepherds. And all of a sudden, I looked up above some trees, and I thought they were on fire, and a glory cloud appeared. And all of a sudden, my dogs sat down. They were at attention, and the Spirit of God spoke out of the clouds. And here's what he said. He said, Hank, I am going to make this nation great again. But then he said this. He said, this is my saying. But he said, what does a nation look like filled with glory? I couldn't answer him. I started weeping. I said, God, I don't know the answer to the question you just asked me. He said, watch. I'm about to show you and others because my glory is coming upon this earth and it's coming fast. And it's for the healing of the nation and signs, wonders, and miracles.
Okay, Richard, you have seen, I mean, few have seen what you have seen in your lifetime, but you and I and Hank, we've never seen the glory of God on a nation. What would that look like to you?
It would look like to me after something that happened in one of my dad's crusades years ago. There was a night, and my father would tell the story if he were here, for about a 14-minute span, everyone he prayed for was healed.
Hmm.
And the next day, we came out to the tent and picked up armloads of crutches and canes and walkers and earpieces and contraptions of all types and description. And the glory of God came into that tent because of the miracles. That's what Hank's talking about. That's what we're going to see again. Right now, there's a person who has you've had some type of dislocation in one of your thumbs, and you cannot move your thumb. You can move your other fingers, but you can't move your thumb. That's being healed right now. And also the migraine that's centered right here and goes across above your eyes, and you can hardly watch the screen on your computer because of the pain. That's leaving you right now. And also, you're going to be able to have freedom and movement in the thumb without any problem whatsoever. You see, God is doing what he did. God is confirming what Hank has prophesied. He's confirming what you're saying, and he's confirming his word by miracles and signs and wonders. And that's what the glory of God is going to look like. When you see the miracles, the glory is going to fall. Because when you get the pattern right, the glory falls. We're getting the pattern right.
You know, Richard, you said to me when we were talking on the phone that when the prophetic and the healing ministry combined, it's greater than either one by itself. And tell me what you mean by that.
Well, one can put 1,000 to flight. Mm-hmm. Two can put 10,000 to flight. When you join together and you're seeing the gifts of the Spirit operating in tandem, and that's what Hank and I saw as we received your invitation to come here to be on this program. We saw the gift of prophecy and the gifts of healing and the word of knowledge flowing in tandem together. And I'll use this illustration. I saw it in my spirit like tag team wrestling, where someone would get a hold, and then they'd reach out and tag the other one, and they come through the ropes, and the other one steps out.
Yeah.
I saw that in the spiritual realm. I saw a word of prophecy, and then a word of knowledge, and then a word of knowledge, and a word of prophecy. I saw going back and forth, and we saw just a moment ago, when I gave a word about cancer, suddenly he gave a word about a job. That's what's happening, and that's what God is doing. And as it happens, the glory of God falls.
Well,
and it tenderizes people's hearts to the name of Jesus.
Hank, anything to add to that? Touch him, tag him.
You tag him. Okay.
No, Richard, you tag him.
You know, one of the things I was going to say, I think this is the reason why there's so much anger and demonic convulsions. The Lord said a lot of the anger and the bickering and the fighting that's going on right now, especially in the United States, is whenever Jesus showed up, he had the spirit without measure. He carried the glory. The enemy would throw himself on the ground. They would protest, act violently because of the glory that was moving in upon
That's
Jesus.
Right.
The glory is moving in among this nation and the earth, whether we like it or not, whether we agree with it, we will not be able to stop it. You know what a nation looks like filled with glory? Watch the Supreme Court when all of a sudden God established, like he said, righteousness and rightness on the courts. And we've got Supreme Court justices that will rule 6-3, 7-2 in favor of the Lord and what he desires. Watch as prayer comes back to our schools and they begin to declare the name of Yeshua across this nation. Watch how Egypt begins to arise and turns and betrays the enemies who have been concealing attacks and assignments against Israel and against the United States. For a season, God's going to use Israel. Why? Because God's glory is coming upon the earth. In fact, Israel, listen. Spirit of God says, it was from you, Israel, that a Savior came to bring salvation and to bring healing. And this is my promise to you, Israel, that from you is coming a healing balm as discoveries are being accelerated now to bring cures to those things that they said, there is no cure. Watch from Israel, it shall be declared, says the Lord.
Well, you know what I believe, Hank? I believe God operates first in the natural,
and then in the spirit,
then in the supernatural. And I believe just as there's going to be these natural cures coming out of Israel and other places, we are going to see the glory on healing like never before.
We're going to see tremendous healing among children.
Yes. Huh.
Tremendous healing among children. Many of you watching right now, you have children, you have sons and daughters, you have grandchildren, you have great-grandchildren. Some of them have been very ill. There's healing coming.
We are going to see this on this show. I want you to reach out to God now, hear his voice, be his voice. Do you need deliverance? Do you need healing? Release your faith. grab hold of that beach ball, that miracle. Yes, thank you, Lord. And I'm going to tell you, from heaven, Eddie James got a song, and it couldn't be better. Guess what it's called? Be Healed.
Yeah. Amen.
Eddie James.
If your heart is broken and your spirit wounded, and you feel like no one is there for you, have your troubles brought you tears, pain, doubt, and fear, and you don't know what to do? I have a word from Jesus tonight. Be healed. Be healed. Rise, take up your bed and go on to do His will. Be healed. Be healed. Let His blood Jesus breaks every fetter. You don't have to stay the same. Be healed. Is your body filled with pain? Do you feel completely drained? Are you tired, needing comfort and rest? Has the doctor given you a report that is bad news, and it seems that everything is hopeless? I have a word from Jesus tonight. He declares, be healed.
Special presentation of Healing and the Prophetic. Call now and get the Healing and the Prophetic package, exclusive to our It's Supernatural audience. It includes Hank Kunneman's book, Prophesy with the Wind of God in Your Mouth, plus his prophetic two-part audio CD teaching, A Throne Room Perspective of the Now, and What Does a Nation Look Like Filled with Glory? And you will receive Richard Roberts' audio CD teaching, Miracles Are Coming Toward You or Going Past You Every Day. All yours for a donation of $29. Shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 9470. You will receive Richard Roberts' anointed audio CD teaching, Miracles Are Coming Toward You or Going Past You Every Day. You will find out how to remove every obstacle to receiving your healing. Learn that this is God's season of His glory being released on planet Earth. Understand the keys to grabbing onto your healing, your miracle, your breakthrough. Richard Roberts prays for God to release to you His healing and your miracle. You will receive Hank Kunneman's book, Prophesy with the Wind of God in Your Mouth. Through this book, you will learn that it's always been God's desire to use His people to speak and be His voice on earth. Learn the key on how to declare and decree words that drive away the enemy and bring deliverance. Declare words that reach heaven, bringing you a spiritual breakthrough of prosperity, restoration, and blessings. You will also receive Hank Kunneman's prophetic audio CD teaching, What Does a Nation Look Like Filled with Glory? Through it, you will learn how the glory will cause ungodly laws to be overturned. wipe terrorists off the face of the earth, cause leaders in high places to cry out for God's mercy and divine wisdom, cause children to be praying in schools again, cause the Supreme Court to overturn abortion, bring about a supernatural wealth transfer and debt cancellation. You will also receive Hank Kuhneman's second audio CD teaching, A Throne Room Perspective of the Now. Through this exclusive audio CD teaching, you will begin to see the world around you through God's throne room perspective. Understand the way of escape from the circumstances and dangers confronting you. Learn how to take advantage of the season of glory being released upon America, Israel, and the nations. Be a part of a mighty revival with stadiums and the streets themselves being filled with miracles, signs, and wonders. Don't miss out on getting the healing and the prophetic package exclusive to our rich supernatural audience. It includes Hank Kuhneman's book, Prophesy with the Wind of God in Your Mouth, plus his prophetic two-part audio CD teaching, A Throne Room Perspective of the Now, and What Does a Nation Look Like Filled with Glory? And you will receive Richard Roberts' audio CD teaching, Miracles Are Coming Toward You or Going Past You Every Day. All yours for a donation of $29. Shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 9470. Call or you can send your check to Sid Roth. It's supernatural. P.O. Box 39222, Charlotte, North Carolina 28278. Please specify offer number 9470 or log on to sidroth.org. Call or write today. And now, back to our special presentation of Healing and the Prophetic.
Before we go off the air, I want to thank our broadcast partners, GB America and METV, Middle East Television. Our next ISN live event is April 20th. David Herzog, Kathy Walters, and Julie Meyer will be with us for this special supernatural glory explosion. And when we leave GB America, this program will continue on METV and ISN, the It's Supernatural Network. So be sure to stay with us to watch on ISN. There's no charge. Just log on to sidroth.org/ISN or download our free ISN app. Just go to the App Store, type in my name, Sid Roth, S-I-D-R-O-T-H, then touch the orange ISN app. And once you've done that, you can watch us anytime, 24/7. Coming up next, never before done, it's going to be a historic tag team healing and prophetic ministry. Richard Roberts will pray for healing and specifically for children. And Hank Kuhneman will have prophetic words for you. And based on what's happened just now, there's no telling what's going to happen on this show, because where the Spirit is Lord, there is liberty. Get to that ISN app on your computer or any smartphone in the world. Stay with us, and we're going to continue on ISN and METTV in just a moment. And I'm going to tell you something. There is a healing presence of God in this studio that is going to go right through your television set, and you get ready to catch it, because God makes a statement. I, God, am no respecter of persons. What I'll do for one, I'm going to do for you right now. Ha! I am in good company. Look who I've got. Richard Roberts on my left, Hank Kuhneman on my right.
And Sid Roth in the middle.
And you in the front, and you watching at home or the bar or wherever you happen to be watching. But this I know, this day, this evening, did not catch God by surprise. He ordained this. He saw you in the seat you're in. He saw you where you are right now. So, Hank, you're the prophet. What's going to happen right now?
Spirit of God's going to continue to descend very, very strong. And specifically what the Lord is saying, you that are in this room, but you that are in the room around the world, what I hear specifically is when the man in the Bible was in his condition for a long time, Jesus came and recognized that he had been in his condition of sickness for a long time. And it wasn't a visitation from a man, from an angel, but from Yeshua, that everything changed. The Lord God himself. The Lord God himself is coming. Right now, I believe he's already here, but his presence is going to grow stronger. And the Lord is coming to minister specifically to those that are suffering and have been in their condition for a long, long time.
I have a question for you. We're broadcasting throughout Israel and the entire Middle East. Has God shown you anything about Prime Minister Netanyahu or what's going on in the Middle East?
Well, for the sake of time, yes, he has. But I will say this about Israel. This is so important. There is coming an acceleration in your technology. The Lord is your light and he's your salvation. Whom do you fear? Fear God. But there is coming an acceleration in the technology that God is going to expose your enemies and he's going to stop them before they're able to strike because of an acceleration of a release of technology. But also, watch, 2020 is very specific. The year 2020 for the world, but specifically for Israel. And there will be a major move of God that will start unfolding and release. And by 2020, we're going to see it globally, but also in Israel. And the prime minister needs not fear because God's backing him and God's backing Israel.
Hank, I like that.
That will be when Israel turns 70.
Oh, I didn't know that.
The reason... And I think the number is specifically important because of the Bible, because what you have said about 70, and remember Jesus sent out 70, and there are a number of references in the scripture to 70. That will be Israel's 70th year, having been founded in 1948.
Also, don't fear North Korea, whether you are Israel or the United States. I prophesied back in February that there would be a sign given that they would have a missile explosion that would fail. Mm-hmm. It just happened. Prophesied that February 5th of this year. And God said, when you see this missile failure, I'm going to embarrass the one in Korea. And God said, it'll be a sign that I'm about to implode his government. And the short one shall not stand tall or have a long reign. So don't fear in Israel. God's dealing with the enemies.
Well, I am going to slip out of this tag team for just a moment, and one of you tag the other because there's a fight going on.
All right,
Hank,
let's go.
There is a cataract in the left eye that is dissolving even as I'm speaking. You've been watching us, and you've been trying to get focused on that eye because of the cataract. You're trying to move your head to look around the cataract, and all of a sudden the cataract is just disappearing, and now it's like just someone's wiping the lens clean. And you're going to be able to see out of that left eye. And then there's also a word of someone who has suffered, yes, I'll do that, Lord, suffered with ulcers for years. Every time you eat, you have the esophagus back up, you have the problem with ulcers and the burning pain, and you don't enjoy eating any longer because you know what's coming after. That's being healed in someone. And also there's someone, you've had a blockage. You've had because of the early spring and the allergies and things of that nature, you've had this problem in your sinuses, and you can't seem to get rid of it, and your nasal passages have been blocked, and you've not been able to breathe properly, which has bothered your sleep, and you are opening up now, and if you'll begin to breathe, someone's going to find their nasal passages are now completely opening, and you'll be able to breathe all the way in and all the way out in Jesus' name.
Richard, I'm seeing what looks in the spirit right now. I thought it was a blanket, but the Spirit of God says, this is my garment being spread over this audience and over the audience in the world. And the Spirit of God says, I ministered healing by way of touch and by way of my words. And so in the name of Jesus of Nazareth, we declare, let the garment of the Lord, the healing garment of God himself, Jesus, Yeshua, let it be released. Let it be released. Let it be released. Healing in the name of Jesus. Every sickness, every disease, come out. In the name of Jesus, be healed. Richard, I see right now in the spirit, there is a woman. She's literally holding a picture of her baby. And she's saying, the baby's in the other room, but you're holding, you don't want to wake up the baby, but you've got a picture of the baby, and you're saying, I want him to do like his father did. I want him to place his hands up where I could put it upon the screen that I might be healed. The Spirit of God says, I healed with my words and I healed with my touch. And I just see in the Spirit, you holding your hand up right now, and I see that person, and I see others that need healing specifically to go ahead and put their hand where your hand is in the name of Jesus.
And the Lord is saying that there's no distance in prayer. There's no distance in prayer. I remember one night, Hank, I was on television, and the Lord said to me, hold up your hand and have people touch your hand as a point of contact. And I said, I can't do that. I don't want someone to think I'm crazy. I don't want someone to think there's something wrong with me or I'm trying to draw attention to myself. And I disobeyed. I didn't do it. And the next night, the same thing happened. And I said, Lord, I don't want to cause people to focus on my hand. And so I called my father afterwards and I said, Dad, here's what the Lord said to me. And I don't want to draw my attention. He began to laugh and he said, do you remember the scripture in Acts when the Bible says God wrought special miracles through the hands of Paul? He said, you have Bible precedent. Don't worry about what somebody thinks about your hand. Stretch out your hand and pray. And that night, I said to the people at home, come over to your television screen or to your computer screen, no matter how you're watching, and put your hand up against my hand and let my hand be a point of contact for the releasing of your faith. So right now, put your hand up against the computer screen or wherever, or your smartphone, or however it is that you're watching us right now, because there is no distance in prayer. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction. Psalm 107, verse 20. So right now, as Hank prophesied it, I do what he prophesied. I send the word to you. I send the power of God that's flowing through me and through my hand right now into your body, into your spirit, into your mind, into your family, into your finances, into your health, into every area of your life. And yes, Lord, I'll say that. I come specifically against the depression and the discouragement. That's one of Satan's great weapons, discouragement and depression. I break that off of you. I curse that. I bind that off of you in the name of Jesus. Discouragement and depression, come out by the authority of the name of Jesus. And I send the word to you for healing from the crown of your head even unto the soles of your feet. Hank, there's a man watching right now. You sit at your desk all day long and you use the computer. You type on the computer and you've developed carpal tunnel syndrome. It's worse in your left hand than your right, and you're being healed right now in the name of Jesus.
Not only are you being healed, but the Spirit of God says you got passed over for a promotion. And the Lord said, wow, when that promotion was passed over, you started noticing that there was that carpal tunnel, that pain in your hands. And God said, there's a connection to forgiveness. Release and say, I forgive that one. And watch what comes into your body by way of the healing power of God. And the Lord says, don't get too comfortable with where you're at, because I'm going to promote you in another place. By the way, Richard, I keep seeing a car accident being played out in my spirit. There's somebody in this room. It's almost like, and you've had tremendous pain in your body, and I feel like it's been just like in the last year or two that you were in a car accident, sideswiped. I see it, and there's been tremendous pain in your body that goes down into your neck and into your spine. Who's that? Is that you? Stand up right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I see, I don't know why I keep seeing like a pickup truck.
Just touch her around her. Just touch her.
In the name
of
Jesus, touch her. Release it out of your mouth.
In the authority of Jesus' name, be healed.
Be healed.
Just like Eddie sang a moment ago, be healed. Be healed. We send the word to you. And there's another person you're watching right now, and you injured your shoulder. And that's another one that you were talking about a moment ago. And now that person's going to be able to lift their shoulder all the way up and all the way down and all the way around. Maybe someone here tonight, just lift your shoulder all the way around. Someone will be able to move it all the way around. It was injured in a car wreck, yeah, just like you were saying, Hank. And there's another word about unforgiveness, Hank, yeah, to what you just said, to add on to what you said. My wife, Lindsay, always says unforgiveness is like, yeah, drinking poison, yeah, and expecting the other person to die. Unforgiveness will not hurt them. It'll just kill you. Let the unforgiveness go. Peter said to Jesus, how many times must I forgive? Seven? Jesus said, no, Peter, 70 times seven. We've been talking about 70 tonight. 70 times seven, or in other words, to live in a state of a forgiveness. Let it go. Let it go. Whatever they did, whatever they said, however they harmed you, whatever damage it did to you, somebody else's fault, a family member's fault, a non-family member's fault, let it go. Forgive them and give them to God. And let Him deal with them in the name of Jesus. Let's all pray this out loud. Father,
Father,
in Jesus' name, I forgive.
I forgive.
I let this one go.
I let this one go.
I give them to you.
I give them to you.
I forgive them.
I forgive them.
Whether they deserve it or not. That's beside the point. I forgive them. Healing's coming right now. I let them go.
Thank you, Lord.
I let them go. I let them go. I let them go. Come on, give praise to the Lord. I let them go. I let them go. I forgive them. I let them go. There's healing. There's healing in that.
Be healed. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Be healed in the name of Jesus. I see a woman. And you've been waking up in the middle of the night, rolling over with a mouthful of acid, like acid reflux, and you've been having a really hard time sleeping. I believe that you're in the back part of this room. Who is that? Is there anybody that you're saying you've been having that? It's been acid, has been coming up from your stomach, up into your throat. Who's that? Wave your hand. I want you to stand up right there. Stand up. That one, the lady with the both of you, stand up, and he's going to minister healing, but I'm going to minister that one right there, you, the blonde. In the name of Yabashivaramohahishike. Spirit of God says, there has been a fight over your family. There has been a fight to discredit, to bring strife, and to divide. And God says, your heart has been heavy. And so because your heart has been heavy over your family and some events that took place in 2015 and carried over into 2016, it wounded you. And God says, you've not been able to sleep. And so the reflux comes up. But God says, not only am I healing you, but I'm healing your family, and you will see a divine turnaround begin to take place. For let your words be the words that Mary said when the angel came. Let it be according to your word, Lord. For this is my promise to you. For you will even see through the night hour that your sleep will be sweet, and there has been a shift that has taken place in your body. God says this is a sign that shall begin to spill out over your family, and watch. There is an apology coming, and they will say, I'm sorry. God says, when they do that, you open your arms wide, and you forgive.
Receive them.
Be healed.
And to the acid reflux, and to that bitter taste in your mouth because of the bitter situation, I rebuke it in the name of Jesus, and I send the word, I send the word, I send the word into you. I rebuke the acid reflux and that acid taste. Come out! In the name of Jesus. And glory to God, it's coming out. Somebody give praise tonight. It's coming out. 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 It's coming out.
It's coming out.
It's coming out.
In the name of Jesus. Richard, I see in the spirit that there has been a recent doctor visit around. There's twofold, one that came in December and another one in January. And the doctors gave you a report that is frightening you. It's scaring you. There's even a something about your blood where they've been speaking and saying that they think that there's a cancerous trace in your blood. I feel like there's someone that in this room, but also you that are watching, that there was a doctor's report, a doctor's diagnosis that happened specifically in the second week of January. There was a doctor's report. It scared you. You're still having tests. There's still things that are going on. If you're in this room, wave your hand. I believe that there's something that's happening here. Listen, in the name of Jesus of Nazareth, we speak now, and we command the healing power of God. We come against the spirit of fear that is trying to attack you in the name of Jesus, to bring you into fear, and we say that there is an opposite report as a divine intervention of God. And I prophesy as the prophet prophesied and said, this time tomorrow, things shall begin to change. Who had a, is there anyone here? You had a doctor's report. Again, I keep feeling like there's something in this room as well in January. If that's you, just wave your hand. Wave your hand in right there. Richard, I feel like you need to speak the word of healing to that one and to that person in the camera too. There's a cancer, blood cancer in the camera also.
It's leukemia.
But also this one. Yeah.
It's leukemia. In the name of Jesus, I come again. Everybody stretch your hands out toward me as a point of contact. You watching with diagnosis of leukemia, in the name of Jesus, I arrest it. Leukemia, come out. I curse this cancer. Leukemia in the blood, come out. And this situation, ma'am, that you're going through, I bind it in the name of Jesus, and I send the word of God to you for healing right now in Jesus' name. Hank, there are...
Also, when this report came, you were all excited, saying this is going to be a glorious year. This is going to be a wonderful year. And then when this happened, it took the wind out of you. But the Spirit of God says, I bring my breath to you. And I breathe upon you with the divine transfer of my grace. And the Spirit of God says, watch the summer months concerning you. For surely you will see that I stood by you in December. I stood by you in January. And I've been standing before you throughout this year. And there is a divine shift. And the Spirit of God says, turn around three times. Turn around. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit, it is sealed over you. It is well.
As Hank was just praying, thank you. Nasal passages opening up right now in the name of Jesus. Someone will be able to breathe all the way in right now in the name of Jesus.
Thanks.
Two words. There are two world-class athletes that are watching tonight live. One is in the arena of track and field, and the other is in the arena of football. I don't know which is which, but one of you has blown out your Achilles tendon. You're concerned that you'll ever be able to run and jump again. And the other has blown out your knee, and you're very concerned about next season. I get the word that the track star is with the Achilles tendon and the knee is with the world-class football player. In the authority of Jesus' name, just put your hand up against your computer screen right now or your smartphone. In Jesus' name, I speak to, glory to God, I speak to the Achilles tendon, just heal up. I see it moving like this, Hank. I see it healing up. And the knee, which has been all blown out now. And they said you might not even get to play next season because of it. No, you will play this next season. You're in rehab right now, and suddenly there's going to be an acceleration. You mentioned earlier about Jesus turning the water into wine. There was an acceleration. There's going to be an acceleration in the rehab. And your therapists and doctors will be amazed that you're able to do what they said you wouldn't do much faster than you thought it possible. God is going to accelerate the healing of the Achilles tendon and accelerate the healing of your knee. And I just give praise and honor and glory to God tonight.
And there is, I keep seeing the number 12. Someone has been in their condition for 12 years. They've been needing healing for 12, specifically speaking to someone who you've had a condition for 12 years. If as I speak to the camera, if that's you also in this room, I want you to wave your hand at us as I acknowledge the camera. 12 years. I specifically see 12 years. And what I see is you've had this excruciating pain that is down in your legs and even in your knees. And in fact, I hear the Spirit of God say to me, Richard, Hank, not just this one, but there are people that are in incredible pain, back pain, heart pain. You know, Jesus came to heal the brokenhearted. And so right now, the Spirit of God is wanting to address pain of the hearts, physically, but also emotionally, and pain in your body. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, we command all pain, come out in the name of Jesus. We speak now to the source of that pain, and we say, be thou made whole in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. I feel like there's someone's birthday or something. Is there someone's birthday? I feel like it's either today or tomorrow. Is there a birthday? When is your birthday? Today. I feel like there's something. Do you need healing? Yes. I feel like part of what God wants to do for you on your birthday is to give you the gift with what you've been crying out for, and that is a touch upon your life and upon your body. And so, Richard, I feel like you need to pray the prayer. Let that birthday present come to you. Let that birthday gift come to you. Anybody else? You that are watching also, you're celebrating a birthday today. You don't need a man. You don't need an angel. You need Jesus himself. He's passing by your way. Lord, is that your birthday too? Okay. Right there, that woman right there. This is so special to the Lord.
On your birthday, in the authority of the name of Jesus, we send the word to you. And I remind you, Psalm 107, verse 20, he sent his word and healed them. We have Bible precedent to send his word and deliver them from their destruction. I send the word to you on your birthday for healing and for everything that he just prophesied to come swiftly into your lives. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah.
With your birthday, the one whose birthday, and you that are watching, I want you to do this. I want you to clap your hands. Just start clapping your hands. Clap your hands. Clap your hands. You, that's your birthday. Spirit of God says there is breakthrough. There is breakthrough. There is breakthrough that is taking place. There is breakthrough. I prophesy breakthrough. Breakthrough. The Lord also says lift up your hands, for there's a financial breakthrough that's beginning to come. It's beginning to come. It's beginning to come.
Hallelujah.
There's been some disappointments. Hope deferred makes your heart sick, but when it springs forth, it's a tree of life. The Lord says, I'm reversing things. Don't let your heart be troubled. Don't let your heart be broken. I'm bringing healing, even to certain disappointments that have frustrated you in this last season. But you are in a new season. And God says, I'm going to cause joy to begin to arise and hope to be restored. I stretch my hands. Richard, I feel like you need to address. There's somebody watching right now, and they're watching. Actually, they came home specifically because their loved one is in the hospital. And they came home knowing that this was going to be broadcast. And they said, we don't want to miss it. They didn't know if they could get it in the hospital room, but I saw them step out of the room. And there it's your husband specifically that is in the hospital. You're afraid, you're scared. And I'm telling you, I see the Lord speaking through you, Richard, specifically with the authority that you carry to cause healing to come unto that husband. And it has to do with, there's something to do with, I'm getting in my spirit, there's something to do with, cardiac arrest, or what do they call that?
Cardiac.
I can't pronounce it, but that's what I hear. Okay, and that's why they're in the hospital.
Hallelujah. And the authority
fix their heart.
Of the name of Jesus. Everybody just lay your hand on your heart right now. If you're watching, lay your hand on your heart, because there's no distance in prayer.
Thank
We're
going to
pray for this husband in the hospital and also over you. In the authority of Jesus' name, I stretch out my hand toward this heart. I say, heart, beat normally.
Yes.
Arterial sclerosis, come out. Arteries, open up. Be plaque free. Heart muscle beat normally, and that part of the heart which is not sparking properly and has caused your heart rate to speed up, I bind that in the name of Jesus, and I also curse all the ancillary fear that has gone with it. I hear the word fear of reoccurrence. Fear of reoccurrence. You've been through a surgery or some procedure, and you have a fear that that's coming on you again. In the name of Jesus, I break that off of you, because God did not give you a spirit of fear. He gave you a spirit of power, love, and a sound mind. Therefore, the source of that fear is the devil. And Satan, I bind you in the name of Jesus. You take your hand off this heart and you take your hand off this mind. I rebuke the fear and the worry and the anxiety over this upcoming visit that you have in the name of Jesus. Use your faith. Let your faith go. One can put 1,000 to flight. Two can put 10,000 to flight. And we agree. And the Bible says, if two shall agree on earth as concerning anything that they shall ask, it shall be done by my Father in heaven. I call it done by faith in Jesus' name.
Okay. I have heard something several times, but I need you to back this prayer up that I'm going to pray right now. In the Bible refers to spirits of infirmity. So many people have spirits of infirmity. They're praying for a healing. All they have to do is get rid of the spirit of infirmity. And I know how. I'm going to pray that every spirit of infirmity will leave. In the name of Jesus, the Messiah of Nazareth, I command, based on the blood of Jesus, the Messiah of Nazareth, I command that spirit of infirmity to be bound and to leave and get under the feet of Jesus, and healing flow. The river of healing is just going to continue all night long. And I tell you this, let every man be a liar, but God's word is true. He sent his word, that's what it says, and healed you. Not someone else. He sent his word and healed you. Ha!
Call now and get the healing and the prophetic package exclusive to our It's Supernatural audience. It includes Hank Kunneman's book, Prophesy with the Wind of God in Your Mouth, plus his prophetic two-part audio CD teaching, A Throne Room Perspective of the Now, and What Does a Nation Look Like Filled with Glory? And you will receive Richard Roberts' audio CD teaching, Miracles Are Coming Toward You or Going Past You Every Day. All yours for a donation of $29. Shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 9470. You will receive Richard Roberts' anointed audio CD teaching, Miracles Are Coming Toward You or Going Past You Every Day. You will find out how to remove every obstacle to receiving your healing. Learn that this is God's season of His glory being released on planet Earth. Understand the keys to grabbing onto your healing, your miracle, your breakthrough. Richard Roberts prays for God to release to you His healing and your miracle. You will receive Hank Kunneman's book, Prophesy with the Wind of God in Your Mouth. Through this book, you will learn that it's always been God's desire to use His people to speak and be His voice on earth. Learn the key on how to declare and decree words that drive away the enemy and bring deliverance. Declare words that reach heaven, bringing you a spiritual breakthrough of prosperity, restoration, and blessings. You will also receive Hank Kunneman's prophetic audio CD teaching, What Does a Nation Look Like Filled with Glory? Through it, you will learn how the glory will cause ungodly laws to be overturned, wipe terrorists off the face of the earth, cause leaders in high places to cry out for God's mercy and divine wisdom, cause children to be praying in schools again, cause the Supreme Court to overturn abortion, bring about a supernatural wealth transfer and debt cancellation. You will also receive Hank Kunneman's second audio CD teaching, A Throne Room Perspective of the Now. Through this exclusive audio CD teaching, you will begin to see the world around you through God's throne room perspective. Understand the way of escape from the circumstances and dangers confronting you. Learn how to take advantage of the season of glory being released upon America, Israel, and the nations. Be a part of a mighty revival, with stadiums and the streets themselves being filled with miracles, signs, and wonders. Don't miss out on getting the healing and the prophetic package exclusive to our It's Supernatural audience. It includes Hank Kunneman's book, Prophesy with the Wind of God in Your Mouth, plus his prophetic two-part audio CD teaching, A Throne Room Perspective of the Now, and What Does a Nation Look Like Filled with Glory? And you will receive Richard Roberts' audio CD teaching, Miracles Are Coming Toward You or Going Past You Every Day. All yours for a donation of $29. Shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 9470. Call or you can send your check to Sid Roth. It's Supernatural. P.O. Box 39222, Charlotte, North Carolina 28278. Please specify offer number 9470 or log on to SidRoth.org. Call or write today.